of our DCC faculty and administrative staff, family members, with special recognition given to those individuals who have reached certain milestone years of service anniversaries. I am pleased to help Dr. Eddington today present the Length of Service Awards to 28 individuals. Collectively, they have served Dutchess for 480 years. Three have served for 35 years. As I call your names, I ask that the recipients come forward to receive your award from Dr. Eddington, and all recipients at the end of the presentation come on stage for the famous group photograph. We'll begin now. The first milestone is 10 years of service back in 2005. Hurricane Katrina wreaked catastrophic damage on the Gulf Coast. 1,000 people lose their lives and millions are left homeless. What a wake story. John Roberts becomes the 17th Chief Justice of the United States Supreme Court. A box office hit that year was Star Wars Episode III, Revenge of the Sith. You remember that one. Dan Rather retired from the CBS Evening News. Super Bowl 39 champions were the New England Patriots. And Natalie Holloway disappears in Aruba. Remember that one? Celebrating 10 years of service today, Anne Marie Andrews. Stuart Dawes. Paula Deltres Jutt, Klaus Gessler, Elizabeth Justin, Melanie Klein, Elaine Marianthopoulos, Diana Pollard, and Donna Rokap. Congratulations to all of you on 10 years of service. That's why you have to sit up front. In the year 2000, 15 years of service, World Series champions were the New York Yankees. Time magazine named Person of the Century to Albert Einstein. Richard Hatch won $1 million in the first season of CBS's Survivor. Charles Schulz, beloved cartoonist of the Peanuts comic strip, died. And mad cow disease was rampant in alarming Europe. Stopped eating meat that year, I think. Celebrating 15 years of service, Susan Conrad, Barbara Delansky, Lowell Handler, Davina Hooker, Cornella Mazuka, Marta Newkirk, Tammy Powell Kopalak, Werner Steger, Daniel Valentine, and last but not least, Robert Zasso. Congratulations on your 15 years of service with DCC. Fly so fast. The next milestone, 1995, 20 years of service. It was the year of the quotes. Houston, we have a problem. No soup for you. And if it doesn't fit, you must acquit. Remember that one? The Rock and Roll Hall of Fame opened that year, Cleveland, Ohio. And Braveheart won the Academy Award. Celebrating 20 years of service, David Teague. Congratulations, David. The next milestones are 25, 30, and 35 years of service. The music you will hear has been shared by many of the recipients as one of their favorite pieces. Colleagues and friends have offered their thoughts and comments to commemorate these anniversaries. Back in 1990, the number one TV show was Cheers, and Seinfeld debuted on NBC. The World Wide Web Internet Protocol was created by Tim Berners-Lee. Have we heard of him? Blockbuster films, Home Alone and Dances with Wolves. Remember those? Celebrity deaths that year, Jim Henson and Sammy Davis Jr. The Hubble Space Telescope was launched. And the Cold War officially ended. East and West Germany were reunited. Celebrating 25 years of service, Joanna Halsey, Karen Ingham, and Andrew Scala. Joanna Halsey. Professor of Mathematics, Department of Mathematics, Physical and Computer Sciences. Joanna embodies the word dedication. Diana Statz, Professor, comments, "It's hardly a hyperbole to say that Joanna has had an incredible impact upon her students, her colleagues, and the college as a whole. The extent of that impact was apparent as soon as she joined DCC in 1990 and spearheaded an initiative to incorporate technology into the college's upper-level math classes. She was the first instructor on campus to explore the benefits of having students write about math. Another accomplishment was Joanna's role in establishing the technology and tutoring learning space, originally called Newton's Corner. Today it's known as the Math Center, and it's an essential resource for students. It was Joanna, along with Ann Landry, who originally applied for funding that service, and through their efforts, DCC was awarded a sizable grant from the National Science Foundation. Joanna has continued to offer innovative thinking that increases the effectiveness of the MPCS department. She has developed detailed technology manuals for students and faculty. Joanna started and for many years led the Math Issues Group, a forum for faculty to discuss curricula issues. Even then, she saw the far-reaching implications of the assessment requirements that surfaced in the early 2000s. Joanna acts as a mentor for colleagues and is the go-to person when dealing with questions on curriculum and policy. She is always one of the first to offer emotional support when a colleague has a personal setback. Joanna has considerable teaching abilities and is an instructor that truly changes lives. She sets the highest standards for her students and conveys her expectations and commitment to excellence in all of her classes. Many students who have completed calculus with Joanna wear their experience as a badge of honor. In 1999, she received national recognition for her excellence in teaching by the American Mathematical Association of Two-Year College Faculty. Joanna's contributions extend far beyond her direct teaching and department activities. While serving on the Disadvantaged Students Committee, she developed a booklet of hot sheets, which is now an invaluable resource for advisors. Joanna served as the DCC representative to the FCCC and treasurer for NYSMATYC. Wow. A New York organization of two-year college math faculty. For many years, the Duke treasurer, she has recently taken on the responsibility of union president. Joanna has done a great deal to bring Duke and the administration together for the common good. She has an unparalleled ability to take on a seemingly intractable problem, forge a plan, rally support, and ultimately resolve the issue. I continue to be awed and inspired by her insights, her seemingly limitless energy, and her commitment to DCC, and that as well is no hyperbole. Marianne Johnson, instructor, says, I'm writing to you regarding the amazing Joanna. She is a supportive colleague and a friend whose kindness, professionalism, and work ethic are surpassed by few. Joanna is always willing to share her thoughts and wisdom, both personal and professional, and brightens each day with her wonderful smile and infectious laugh. I concur. She is one of the most positive people I know, and even when the day is not going well, she can always find the silver lining. Even with the extreme demands on her time due to her involvement as president of the union, Joanna makes time to cooperate and collaborate with faculty in her department and others, and offers insight on a multitude of issues of concern to the department and the college. She has been a leader among us and works tirelessly to enhance student learning and understanding. Joanna is an outstanding educator who cares deeply about her students and encourage them to be successful both academically and personally. While she holds the bar high for student achievement, she gives them every opportunity to do well. And one of her many creative efforts, Joanna initiated a plan she calls Success Strategies into her courses to help students improve their self-confidence and academic skills, and thereby, in doing so, improve their academic grade. I am thankful and blessed to have Joanna as a colleague and a friend. DCC is truly a better place due to your positive impact that you have had on so many facets of this fine educational institution. Please join me in congratulating Joanna on 25 years of dedicated service. Chairperson, Medical Laboratory Technology and Phlebotomy, Department of Allied Health and Biological Sciences. Holly Malella, Dean of Academic Affairs, says, Karen joined DCC full-time in 1990. She received a bachelor's degree from the State University of New York at Plattsburgh and a master's degree from the State University of New York College at New Paltz. Every evaluation Karen has had since she joined DCC talks about her excellent job of creating a positive learning environment in both in the classroom and rigorous standards in her programs. A high priority of Karen is also to continually improve the MLT curriculum, along with providing excellent advisement for her students. As a department chair, Karen is known for her stable and effective leadership. Comments from her department indicate she goes above and beyond her normal duties and has earned their respect with her professional interactions. Faculty and staff feel empowered under her guidance. We are truly lucky to have Karen as part of our DCC family and celebrate with her on 25 years of quality service to our students and steady leadership on our campus. Congratulations, Karen, on 25 years of service. Biology, Department of Allied Health and Biological Sciences. Karen Ingham, department head, states, Andy is certainly dedicated to his profession. He loves what he does, and his students quickly realize that their academic success is important to him. Andy provides his students with such an unprecedented level of guidance, direction, and effective instruction, and many often return after graduation to personally thank him. The decisions he makes are always student-centered. Andy continually strives to conduct his courses and labs with the best interest of his students in mind. He incorporates technology, when appropriate, into his instruction, yet values the importance of fundamental concepts. Even after all of these years, Andy continues to bring an impressive balance of energy and enthusiasm to his professional endeavors. This fervor excites his students and the subject matter and the learning process. This positive attitude also serves as a stimulus to all of his colleagues, often resulting in a casual yet reciprocal dialogue between faculty about the academic situation at hand. As much, Andy often serves as a mentor to less experienced faculty as he freely shares his experiences, teaching strategies, and assistance with others. Andy is a gifted professor and a fabulous colleague. A spring semester student said, "Dr. Scala is a great teacher and his style of teaching has helped a lot in my success." Another wrote, "Dr. Scala is extremely knowledgeable with good analogies of the significance of material to real world applications. And Dr. Scala is very helpful and concerned with what's best for his students." Please join me in celebrating 25 years of service. Congratulations, Andy. Years of service. The quote of that year was, and I'll try it, "You look marvelous!" Billy Crystal. The Titanic was found 370 miles from Newfoundland. David Letterman's first top 10 list appeared that year. It was the top 10 words that almost rhyme with peas. Coca-Cola attempted to change its 99-year-old formula. Some things aren't best changed. And record of the year, "What's Love Got to Do with It" by Tina Turner. Celebrating 30 years is Marianne Longhi, Associate Professor of Office Technologies, Department of Business Technologies. Michael Arroyo, Department Head, states, "Marianne's long career at DCC actually started in prison." No, she's not a criminal, but she has educated many in the prison system in order to provide them with hope for a better life. Marianne was eventually paroled to the main campus and focused her talents in the office technologies program in the business department. She is known to many adjunct business faculty as their evening supervisor and has established many wonderful relationships with her colleagues. Always helpful, Marianne has served on every committee at the college. She has also served as an advisor for Alpha Beta Gamma, the Business Honor Society. Marianne is dedicated to her students and cares a great deal about them. She is very approachable, and many students come to talk to her, not just about school, but about their lives. Marianne has been a great colleague as well. Being a very active DU member, serving many years on the events committee. Outside of DCC, she is an avid traveler and spends her vacations in Florida, Mexico, and St. Martin. Lucky you. Thank you, Marianne, for your dedication to the business department and the college over the past 30 years. Please join me as we wish much congratulations to Marianne. Now we're back. to 1980, 35 years of service. In 1980, the Stanley Cup champions, New York Islanders. John Lennon was shot and killed by a fan, Mark David Chapman. A computer modem was invented. Whole Foods was founded in Austin, Texas. Six U.S. embassy aides escaped from Iran with Canadian help. Ronald Reagan was elected president. And the album of the year was 52nd Street by Billy Joel. Some of you may remember that album. 35 years of service is being celebrated by Karen Desmond, Inga Grutzner, and Francis Whittle. Karen Desmond, Professor of Nursing, Department of Nursing. Inga Grutzner, Department Head, states, "There is not enough time to list all of the accomplishments Karen has achieved over 35 years. So in an attempt to condense, first the numbers. She has spent over 1,155 contact hours with students, 17,000 hours correcting care plans, and held 4,200 office hours. Second, her teaching accolades. Karen is enthusiastic about her subject matter, organized, creates an atmosphere supportive of educational growth, demonstrates mastery in the classroom, and is a positive role model for students. She assisted the Advisement Center, helping students choose their career path, and volunteered in the library, helping barcode over 100,000 volumes. Karen represented the college and nursing department at many community functions, and as a result, DCC has certainly benefited by her knowledge and expertise. She served from 2008 to 2012 on the Mental Health Subcommittee of the Dutchess County Department of Mental Hygiene, and was appointed in 2012 to the Dutchess County Board of Health. Karen and I started the same year at DCC, and our paths ran parallel until I became department head in 2012. Then a true collaboration began, which is characterized by two things. The first is the way we approach our work. I tend to approach an issue with my foot on the gas, whereby Karen will hover over the brake pedal. Typically, her comments end with, "I'm just saying." When I hear these words, I listen most of the time. The second and most important is that Karen functions as my social conscience. She reminds me and everyone in the department to pay attention to the important things in life and to keep our priorities straight. Whenever I hear those words, I listen all of the time. Congratulations to Karen on 35 years of service. Celebrating 35 years of service, Ingeborg Grutzner, Professor of Nursing and Department Head, Department of Nursing. Holly Malella, Dean of Academic Affairs, states, "Inge came to DCC with a nursing diploma from University Hospital in Frankfurt, Germany. She is also a Dutchess graduate and has a bachelor's from Regents College and a master's from Pace University and Marist College. Inga began her career at DCC as an adjunct in the nursing department and later became a nursing lab assistant. In 1989, she was appointed as an instructor in the nursing department and currently is a full professor and department chair. Over the years, Inga has been involved in many campus activities, such as blood drives, committee work, including promotion and tenure in disadvantaged students, was a prime mover for promoting computer use in nursing, for both faculty and students, and co-advisor to the nursing club. Inga is recognized as a valuable contributing member of the nursing faculty, a true professional, and a humanitarian. She is most concerned about her students and always works to improve the nursing curriculum. Inga is a real asset to DCC, and we congratulate her on her 35 years of service. Congratulations, Inga." last today is Francis Whittle, Professor and Program Chairperson of Computer Information Systems, Department of Engineering, Architecture, and Computer Technologies. Frank is a student focused and responsible for placing innumerable students in internships and full-time employment at Dutchess and the surrounding countries. He has served on all major committees, the Dutchess County BOCES Trade Advisory Committee, and the Governor's Task Force on IT and the Regional Economic Council. Frank has taught more than 25 different courses in two departments, business and enact, developed over 20 new courses across a wide spectrum of the IT field, created two-year degree programs in both computer information systems and information management, created certificate programs in web administration, computer support, computer networking, and C++ Java programming, chaired the CIS programs, and held evening supervision since 1985, staffing approximately 25 course sections each semester. He's completed over 70 credits in coursework while teaching at DCC and authored a textbook in mainframe operating systems. He has remained knowledgeable in a field constantly undergoing dramatic change and expansion. Frank played an important role in retraining IT professionals during the IBM downsizing. He taught programming and concepts on mainframe platforms, followed by internet web serve platforms, and now programming apps for mobile platforms such as phones and tablets. Frank also works at AT&T in the engineering database area. And in his spare time, he enjoys playing guitar and piano, as well as a variety of outdoor sporting activities such as tennis and golf. Mark Courtney, department head, states, "There is perhaps no other faculty member at DCC who has seen such radical changes in the field, in his field. He has seen changes in the fields of computing, data processing, and information technology. Does anyone remember when computer programs were written on punch cards? And you submitted your box of punch cards? And if one was out of place or there was a typing error, you had to do it all over again? It wouldn't work. Does anyone still remember floppy disks and the Microsoft Disk Operating System, MDOS? This was the world of computing when Frank started. During his tenure, we've seen the birth of the personal computer, email, the internet, Google, Facebook, laptop, tablets, iPods, iPads, online education, smartphones, phone apps, and much, much more, and much, much more to come. Frank has kept up with all of it, bringing these new computing advances into our curriculum as each one has appeared. Who knows what might be next? Whatever it is, we can bet that Frank will be on top of it. And of course, we cannot fail to mention that over the years, Frank has been a golf and tennis partner with some of the big wigs here on campus. No wonder he has such a nice office suite. Frank, hearty congratulations from all the members of Enact Department and the significant milestone in your career. Thank you for your contributions to our campus. Congratulations. Spend the better part of our lives together, many of us more than 8 hours a day, and we call each other family because family is made up of those who we choose to hang out with and be together. Today we celebrate all of us and we celebrate each other. Enjoy. Thank you. speech when the presentation is over.
Remember, because it was very uneventful. So, but so did Leo get to open it? What's better? He wouldn't tell you, you could come over?
No, we actually didn't want to be his party.
Oh. Oh, you thought you'd be overwhelmed by him.
Yeah, something like that.
No, we went to the
I'm going. Oh, you know what? Maybe I should duck.
Yeah,
I've
been ducked.
Thank you for coming. Please come up to the stage and have your picture taken. And enjoy the rest of the semester. We're
going to
do great things.
She was great. Because
I know the work. I used to work with Lenny. Where's the phone jack and stuff? I don't know. They didn't tell us to put that back on. I said it's because they closed up the window. Yeah, they closed. Well, it used to leak a lot.
Happy
I said, Lenny, between closing the window and taking out all the air, you made a closet. This is not an office. It's a closet. I said, you can't put the game. Just can't you put the phone out in the lab? Imagine you lab with a phone. I said, it's not an office. You're supposed to have a computer in there. So I'm going to mention it. I mentioned it. Parks was up there that they were supposed to, you know, they run it out along the wall with a little box. So they said they would forward it on to the crew that were here. That's it. Well, I was asking Lenny, why did you close the window? He goes, well, we're having trouble sealing it. We just have to screw it, cover it over. From the outside, the window's there, but you're looking at the backside of the wall board. That's what I said.